I'm not saying what is your evidence for this, prove it. No, it's not like that. Yes. But it is, what is it that gives you this conviction? I believe you see, you're shining with conviction.
Yeah, yeah.
What is it?
I may well be totally psychotic, Bernard. I mean, I don't know whether... I'm at the point, this is, me as a social scientist is appalled by who I would lock me up. I mean, who I was 50 years ago would lock me up now. Mm-hmm. Because I don't even say I hypothesize or I theorize. I say this is just the way it is.
Right.
And as far as I can see, there are three ways you know these kinds of things. One is by your direct experience, and through the drug experiences, through the meditation experiences, through being around my guru and so on, being in India a lot. A lot of things have happened that have reinforced these kinds of belief systems. The second way is that you know somebody who knows, and they tell you how it is, and you trust them. And that's my relation to my teacher in India, my guru, who died in 73 but didn't go anywhere. I mean, he's more part of my reality now than practically anything else. That's how Mashugana I am now. The third one is that you extrapolate from what you know through your studies, all right? Now, some way, in some combination of all those three things, is the way in which it all becomes real in that way, or relatively real. I mean, everything I'm saying is a lie, because words are birds. They're just flying through the space, and the truth has no form. So I know I'm merely playing with words, and everything is just metaphor and image. We're merely the finger pointing at the moon. We're not the moon. You understand? And I'm in this funny business of talking about the unspeakable, you know?
You had a teacher, a guru. Do we all need a teacher? Do we all need a guru?
Well, everybody has as much guidance as they need. It's all happening perfectly. I mean, that's just what's so mind-blowing. The thing is just unfolding for each person so perfectly. And everybody doesn't need an external person that comes along and says, I am a guru, which I am not, no matter how you introduce me, all right? I'm not enlightened, I'm, you know, just working, just like everybody else. I don't think that everybody needs an external guru. A lot of people have internal gurus. There's a Ramana Maharshi said, God, guru, and self are one, right? And so you can go into your own heart and learn to listen deeper and deeper and deeper. We in the West call it the intuitive mind, as opposed to the rational mind. And we've always kind of put it down or said, well, it's kind of soft and mushy. But that, it turns out to be a higher way of knowing. Like Einstein said, I didn't arrive at my understanding of the basic laws through my rational mind. And if you go into people like Mozart or any numbers of musicians, you'll find people go beyond form into the place where music is, where poetry is, where wisdom is, and then come back and bring it back into knowledge or form.
All right. Well, all I can say is if you don't think you're an enlightened man or a teacher, you could have fooled me. Thank you very much, Ramdas.
Thank you.